Like Sirius Sam, the first encounter? It's okay, I guess. Well, it was a little bit new wave for my taste. But with music that cannot be rivaled and gameplay which is exhilarating, you clearly get down to the best gaming experience of your whole life. As you remember, the game starts as with little weaponry as possible and lots of enemies. Ah yes, when you remember, the Great Pyramid is the last level where you have to fight the final boss, Ugzan III. Is that a fucking fake final boss? Whatever the fuck that is, it's easy. No, you idiot. It's fucking hard. Yes, it is hard. Well, listen to this great soundtrack released as the final level starts. Hope it gets you to move, alright? Remember, it is really exhilarating. But if you really cannot beat the boss on hard difficulty, then you deserve to be castrated, you know? Hey, listen here! Hello guys, welcome, my name is Barugon1966, also as the Sixth Doctor, and today I'm gonna talk about in a faster-than-light review on Sirius Sam, the First Encounter, and take you back to 2001. The gaming industry explored new depths of creativity with such games as Half-Life. The first-person genre got a new light. But there is this one game from a then not known developer, Crow Team, showcasing their new engine, the Sirius engine. This game was Sirius Sam, the First Encounter. The game was originally conceived as a half-priced tech demo. It had been in the making since 1996 and was showcased in 2000. The start of the game is when you realize the setting and the music hits your conception of reality and captivates it with the gameplay moving forward. Egyptian themed levels and 10 weapons of mass destruction. That's a combo of the best gaming experience of your life. Countless enemies to fight and difficulty which will keep you on your toes the whole way. The adrenaline rush of the single player campaign, which can also be played on co-op, continues into the multiplayer, also mainly the team deathmatch and capture the flag modes. But the HD remaster version of the game, which was later released in the early 2010s, it has been explored more with such modes as Beast Hunt. When you run through the levels such as Oasis, Karnak and Luxor, it is a blast to go through. To this day, difficulty rises as the game moves forward because the enemy's number increased dramatically and your ammunition will be lower. You will have sections such as the sewers and metropolis suburbs which need to be mastered to move forward. But let me tell you just this one thing. If you can do the metropolis suburbs on medium difficulty in one try, you will get a cookie from me. Now, as a bonus, because you already had so much things in the game, but there are bonuses as well. There are levels which are secret. One of the best levels in the whole game is a secret level named Moon Mountains, which can be acquired by using a pendulum at the end of the Valley of the Kings. It is well hidden, but also well-known secret. It all leads to a bombastic showdown at the Great Pyramid. The adrenaline is high, ammo is low, enemies are many, including those motherfucking berserkers and clears, which you cannot fucking jump out of their way of, Jesus Christ. And also there is Ugzan III, final boss. The game really gets into the groove of things when you master the whole thing and you get to that final boss. So, overall, the game is brilliant with a bombastic soundtrack and balls-to-the-wall action. I recommend it. Today, it can be bought in many different editions, such as the Classics Revolution, an HD version, which if you buy it, you also get a Fusion, which is just a combination of the two HD edition of the games. And if you have a VR headset, you can also get a VR edition. These can all be purchased on Steam.com, and the game gets a big 10 out of 10 from me. This was a shorter video, but stay tuned because I'm not gonna take 8 months off this time. So production on the next video will begin shortly. See you guys in the next video.